Labor MPs have been warned they cannot afford a repeat of the damaging leaks that wrecked their election campaign, but a reinvigorated opposition is warning the Prime Minister she will live in a world of hurt.
A standing ovation for Julia Gillard from a relieved and diminished Labor caucus.
It's our first caucus meeting of a new Labor government.
While the Prime Minister urged MPs not to dwell in the past, Tasmania's Dick Adams and South Australia's Nick Champion made a pointed reference to the dumping of Kevin Rudd by urging ministers to show loyalty to their leader. They also want MPs to be more critical in the party room.
It's a call to get back to what makes us strong. And in that sense, I think it's a welcome call.
Ms Gillard warned against the sort of leaks that so damaged her election campaign.
I hope they have plastic knives at the cabinet table with Kevin Rudd sitting next to Julia Gillard.
The PM called for discipline, crucial against an opposition scenting blood.
This government's going to have everything coming at it from the Liberal and National parties.
Tony Abbott, their warrior chief, given a rousing reception.
We have not become a government, but we have made our country proud of the Liberal and the National parties.
He proudly welcomed a dozen new MPs, including the youngest ever, Wyatt Roy, given a hug from Parliament's longest-serving member, Philip Ruddock. The new Parliament will sit in 2 weeks' time. Labor is determined to show minority government can work and that it's legitimate. Julia Gillard is planning to have her new cabinet sworn in next week. She's still to hear if independent Rob Oakeshott will join it. Tony Abbott will name his shadow cabinet soon after. His deputy, happy to have escaped a challenge from Andrew Robb. Paul Bongiorno, 10 News.